lovely Daniel once said, if you're an artist and still don't use NFT, you're potentially missing millions of dollars. Good evening and a very warm welcome to a new session on NFTs and their IPR rights, conducted by International Center for Intellectual Property Laws, an initiative by Law Essentials. NFT, or the non-fungible token, blew up in 2020, climbing to a market value of at least $338 million. But what made them blow up? Can't anyone with an active internet connection today view the viral cat gif that sold for $580,000? What gives them that exorbitant price? Moreover, with the inclusion of not just the crypto world, but the art industry, what would be the rights of an artist when he sells his artwork as a token of transaction? Would this new token owner take up the rights of his work? These are pertinent questions that keep hovering around our minds but remain unanswered. Today we have with us Advocate Sai Sushant, a cyber law expert, a techno-legal consultant, and CEO of Sushant IT Law Associates. With his rich knowledge in the information technology, its laws, and intellectual property, he will in no time help us find our ways around NFTs and their IP rights. Thank you so much for joining us, sir.
Thank you so much. Very good evening to all the participants who are part of this webinar, as also who are going to watch us on YouTube. So, It's indeed my pleasure to address once again upon this very good forum that's doing a lot of work on intellectual property and the related issues. Once again, congratulate the International Center for IPR for hosting these kinds of webinars, because these are some things that are not very commonly spoken of in any of the conventional IPR webinars, because we see that the space of technology is moving at such a pace that it's unimaginable. And likewise, the intellectual properties relating to these kinds of technology-related aspects are something that are to be discussed, debated, and a lot of interaction and deliberation are required in this direction. So I would once again like to thank the Center, as also Law Essentials, for this wonderful opportunity, and both the moderators for today's sessions, Farhan and Maitreyi. And once again, would like to thank them for giving me this wonderful opportunity for coming up and sharing with you these concepts on NFT and IPR. So with this context, I think I would like to go ahead and then talk to you about the different kinds of IP and IP-related issues arising out of NFTs. Can you have the PPT connected in the meantime?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So fundamentally, before we get to, I think I just want to give you a small introduction about NFTs. NFTs basically are unique digital assets, specifically they're tokenized assets, which are minted, recorded, and traded specifically on this technology platform called blockchain. So fundamentally, when I talk of blockchain, let me just give you a small overview on how blockchain, what blockchain is and how it operates. Consider that all of the participants who are watching us or who are connected to us today are blocks. How are we connected? Thanks to the organizers, we are all connected. So just imagine each of us to be a block, and we're all connected by the organizers. So the organizer becomes the main person who's actually trying to operate this blockchain. It becomes a blockchain provider. And then in order to join us, you need to, specifically either a meeting ID would be given to you. You'll have to go and enter your details over there and get access to this. Or on YouTube, you'll have to specifically go to this link of this webinar and then open up and then try to see. So just imagine that this is the kind of a security mechanism that is given by the organizer. So in a blockchain, typically all the blocks are connected, and there is an element of security which is by way of cryptography. And all of us who are part of this webinar are only eligible or having the right to see what is there on the screen and PPT. Other people may not be able to watch it right now, but for those of the people who are watching us on YouTube, probably they will be able to do that. But provided you go to the link. So that's very, very important. So unless you're on the block, so taking this webinar to be a blockchain and all the participants to be all the blocks, we're all connected through the organizers. And whatever you're seeing on the screen, you can only see, but you cannot edit, you cannot do any modifications, you cannot do any additions or deletions to the content. And typically in a blockchain scenario, what really happens is once the information or data is put on a block, there is no way you can alter it or modify it or do any alterations to the data. If you want to do any alterations, you will have to add another data and another block, and then that gets itself attached to this original block. So this is the reason why blockchain is preferred, because the main fundamental area that the blockchain possesses is it is decentralized and it has the beautiful characteristic of immutability. That means no possibility to tamper or do any alterations. So now when I talk about NFTs, see, NFTs are something that are traded using blockchain technology, and they're verified using this particular technology. And what is the advantage of this? If you ask me, the fundamental advantage is the authenticity and the ownership of this particular asset can actually be determined using blockchain technology. So let me give you an example. We are all lawyers or law students. So just think, for example, that if I were to store land records of a particular property using blockchain, I think that to a great extent gives you a complete transparency upon the ownership of that particular piece of land. So usually we have issues relating to titles and title ownerships when it comes to property disputes. But when you make use of this blockchain technology, the initial owner who has acquired that particular piece of land till the latest owner who is actually planning to sell this piece of land, I think all the ownership details are recorded on blocks, and all of these data is stored in a chronological manner, and there is no possibility to tamper. And if there are any additional items or if there are any modifications per se, everything gets itself stored in a different block altogether, and it's stored in a chronological order. So thereby, the entire the concept of title disputes can be withered away with the help of technologies like blockchain. So just imagine the same to be applicable in case of NFTs. So if you're an artist, if you're coming up with a wonderful piece of artwork, whether be it a painting, whether be it a musical composition, be it anything which is relating to even a Facebook post or a tweet, or for that matter, a WhatsApp message, anything. Probably if you're an artist and you would like to protect your artwork, I think one of the best forms is NFTs. And you can not only protect it, but you can also monetize it. So that's one of the very wonderful features that NFT gives you. So the ownership and authenticity is something that will be absolutely verified using blockchain technology. So therefore, you can be rest assured that there may be some authenticity and some kind of genuinity with regard to the NFTs, which are nothing but unique digital assets. But the problem here is all these things are very, very interesting to discuss. But when it comes to the realistic aspect, I think that's something that we'll all have to understand probably. Because when you try to create NFTs for an artwork, that's where the problem comes into picture. We have lots of legal challenges. We have lots of interesting areas that we need to examine specifically from an IPR perspective. And all that glitters cannot be gold. So therefore, everything that's available or that can be made use of, everything that can get capable of getting itself into an NFT cannot be something that can be very easily or otherwise available without any legal hassles. So let's go ahead and then try to examine the various kinds of IPR related aspects from an NFT perspective. I just give you a brief, concise overview today, because this is something that requires a lot of discussion, deliberation, and debate, because we don't have in India at the minute any law governing blockchain or any law governing NFTs or any law governing cryptocurrency. One of the major aspects here is it's also going to be the concept of cryptocurrency that will come in. So we'll discuss as we go forward. But just to give you an idea, NFTs are something which are already now starting to emerge as one of the key trends of intellectual property laws. Farhan, can we go to the next slide? Yes. Now, I think the Bollywood industry is completely on NFTs. They're trying left, right, and center to actually try to make their artwork visible through NFT, as also monetize NFT for a good amount of monetizing money. We've recently seen that the legendary actor Amitabh Bachchan also started to have his own NFT collection, and the same was auctioned for over 7 crore rupees, and the same was set as a record. So, what does it mean? It means that everybody who's an artist is now trying to make use of NFTs, and they're trying to come up with their own digital token, and they're trying to monetize it. So that's going to be very, very interesting from a legal perspective, specifically from an IPR perspective, because there'll be lots of questions that come that crop up in the scenarios. For example, let's basically talk about the IP issues in a fundamental manner. For example, when you want to create an NFT, are you really having the ownership, or do you have a license to create that respective NFT? That's something that we'll all have to question ourselves. Because when it comes to the example of film industry, I think it's a different ballgame altogether. Because as you know, in film industry, a lot of intellectual properties get entangled, and they're owned by different actors, in the sense that the director, the producer, the production house, and the musicians, I mean the music directors, lots of people, lyricists, were involved over here. So we'll just try to go ahead and just try to understand that as we go forward. But just to tell you that the latest trend is that the Indian Bollywood industry is also now going across, and then they're trying their waters on NFTs per se. Can we go to the next slide, Farhan? The EA games, which are very, very popular games during the mid-90s, I think they were the first people to come up with different kinds of computer games relating to sports. We had very interesting sports like FIFA and the Cricket World Cups, and other kinds of racing games like Need for Speed and all of these, which were the creations of this very, very interesting company called EA Sports. Now, EA Sports is of the opinion that these NFTs are also part of the future gaming industry. So even games are now going to be involving the concept of NFTs. So that's a very, very interesting scenario as we go forward. Because today, in the generation that we are all in today, I think there are lots of things that are moving on. We have these Xbox, we have PlayStation 5, and things like that. We're making use of a very, very interesting segment of video games, and be very interesting to see how these video games also involve the concept of NFTs. So that's very, very interesting per se. Just imagine you're playing a game, and then you can have the ability to create NFT out of the game that you play, and that NFT you can sell it, monetize it for a... Wow, I think that's going to be a very, very different kind of a concept altogether. Yes, Fahan, can we go to the next slide? Yes, the Warner Brothers are also looking at launching the Matrix NFT avatars with blue pill and red pill options. I think this is something that we all are actually fancied of. When it comes to the Hollywood movies, I think we see that NFTs can left, right, and center be sold for millions of dollars, given the fact that they have a lot of what do you say, people who are admirers of these, and it's the best opportunity for people to actually try to monetize it and earn some value out of these NFT tokens per se. Can we go to the next slide, Farhan? Yes. Now, what becomes very, very interesting is, can these NFTs be trademarked? See, that's a very, very interesting question, because the reason here is that anything that you create becomes a particular brand. So just say that, I want to launch my NFT collection as an artist, and definitely there would be certain amount of trademarks involved. Either trademarks may be involved in the NFT, or the moment I create an NFT, it may also be creating different kinds of trademarks per se. So if I the moment I create my own NFT, will that NFT be capable of getting protected under the trademark law? That's a very interesting question, because I believe that the branding in NFT is something that would add a lot of value to the monetizing aspect. So when it comes to the trademark aspect, because anything that is capable of getting protected in the trademark, you have the logos, you have the images, you have the special characteristics, you have the alphabets, and you have a lot of things which are capable of getting themselves protected under trademark. But what becomes very interesting in this scenario is that can these NFTs be capable of getting themselves protected under trademark law? I think that's a very interesting question per se, because if not, then there'll be a different ball game altogether. Not just that, when it comes to the concept of existing trademarks being used in the NFTs, I think that also is going to bring about a different kind of IP challenges per se from a trademark law perspective. Because do these specifically have the rights? Let's say, for example, I'm making use of a movie clip and then I'm creating an NFT. That NFT definitely would have the element of a trademark, because it would obviously be, if I'm using a famous, movie's name or anything like that, or a character, then obviously if they're protected under trademarks, then it will also be posing a lot of trademark infringement related issues. So that's also something that is very important as far as NFTs are concerned. Because when you create an NFT, automatically intellectual property is getting created. And when it comes to trademark, yes, can I go ahead and file a trademark for my NFT? That's going to be very interesting per se. So that's another area that we all need to really quickly understand from an IPR perspective. Fahan, can we move to the next slide? Yes. No, another very, very interesting area that's likely to be part of our discussion today is NFTs and copyright. Now, the copyright aspect is something that would create a different kind of an analysis altogether from an NFT perspective. The reason here is that when I create an NFT, definitely there's an intellectual property that is getting generated. Now, the fundamental question is that, is my NFT capable enough of copyright protection? Because copyright protects certain areas like musical recordings, and you have these literary works, you have softwares, you have which are poetry, books, all the other literary areas. We have codes. Ultimately, all these are nothing but information or data in the electronic format. So can these be considered as, can NFTs be considered as a literary work under the Copyright Act? I think that's a very, very interesting question per se that we all need to clearly examine. And more specifically, when you look at the copyright law, it says that the creator or the developer becomes the first owner of copyright. So just imagine if I create an NFT, do I become the first owner of copyright? I think that's a very interesting question. But what remains as a legal challenge here is that if I collate different materials from different sources and come up with my own NFT, then would I be eligible to become the first owner under copyright? That's a very, very, very interesting challenge this particular ownership issue brings in on the table. Because the fundamental area is that when I purchase an NFT that is relating to any creative work, then what happens if it's an, if it's a painting, if it's anything to do with a video, all of these areas, then how am I to actually try to put this? Because normally what happens is that the buyer receives the copy of this particular NFT and the tokens get added onto the buyer's digital wallet. But when there is a sale of NFT, what happens is that there's a copy of the creative work and the same is then communicated to the buyer. So just imagine if I have a unique piece of painting created by an artist, So which is original and which is going to be a copy, that's going to be a challenge. So if, when I do a sale of my artwork, specifically by using NFT, there's going to definitely be a copy that is going to be created out of this creative artwork. And the same would be communicated to the buyer. So what becomes important is that that's this copy amount to copyright infringement. Will this copy be considered as an unauthorized reproduction or distribution or adaption per se? So that's a very interesting question. We don't have definitive answers, but I believe that this should be the areas that people should be really able to understand before they actually put up or go ahead and make use of NFTs for their artworks. Not just that, what's going to be very challenging is, as an intellectual property owner, I have got various rights. For example, I've got the right to license my work. I've got the right to actually monetize it in part or full. I've got the opportunity to license it in part or full or for a particular period of time. Then there's going to be assignment. I can assign it for a particular period of time or for a particular amount of consideration and things like that. In these kind of scenarios, what becomes important is owning an NFT versus owning the rights in the respective NFT. See, those become very, very important per se. Because the ownership of that artwork itself is something which is very tricky. Because the seller is actually having an opportunity under the Copyright Act to actually assign the ownership while selling this NFT. So, but I think these are all some fundamental areas that require a lot of discussion and deliberation per se. But what my experience is that, you know, merely selling an NFT and getting some rights transferred to you would be something that we all have to understand and specifically talk about. Because by default, an artist retains the copyright of the copyright ownership over his artwork. But merely by selling the NFT, is he just giving up a license or is he transferring the right? I think those will be two fundamental questions that will crop up when I talk about you know, NFTs and copyright per se. Because most of these NFT sales that are actually happening across these NFT marketplaces merely give you a license to use the digital copy, but the original authorship or the original ownership was with the copyright owner per se. So if I'm an artist, I will just give you a license by the way of the NFT sale, and I, as a artist, would retain the copyright over my artwork or property ownership over my artwork. I think that's also something that's very, very important that we all have to consider. I think you know, lots of these issues will crop up. Let's go to the next slide, please. Yes. Now, when we do a legal analysis with respect to creation and sale of NFT, there are going to be lots of IP related issues that will crop up here. So, what are these issues? Let's discuss by taking a small kind of an example. One second. Just wait for a second, please.
Surely, sir.
Yes. Now, when we talk about creation and sale of NFTs, I was just trying to tell you about the example of a movie clip. So if there is a single owner, then there is not going to be much of complication when you actually try to create and sell NFTs through NFT marketplaces and things like that. But What becomes very, very challenging is if there are multiple owners involved, then that's going to create a lot of different kinds of legal challenges. Just like in a movie, let's take that example that you would like to create an NFT of a movie clip. I think when you make use of a movie clip, there are going to be multiple stakeholders in this scenario because there would be the producers, and if you're using a particular a dialogue or a particular scene in a particular movie, then there would be background score. Then if there is a song involved, then there's going to be lyrics that are going to come in. I think all of these involve different kinds of stakeholders. So when there are different kinds of stakeholders involved here, I think it's very, very different matter. The concept of IP ownership of different owners, because different people own different things in a movie, and I think it's going to bring in a different kinds of IP challenge altogether. Because when you create and sell such kinds of NFTs, I think the licenses need to be obtained from those people. Proper permissions would be required in these areas. I think a lot of different kinds of work is involved in this scenario. It's not a very simple affair that's that would arise in this particular scenario, because it involves multiple stakeholders and specifically multiple IP owners to come together. So that's something that we'll all have to do a proper analysis before creating and selling such kinds of NFTs. So that's something that we'll all have to quickly understand. Farhan, can we go to the next slide, please? Yes. Now, no doubt that what I was just discussing with you initially, NFTs definitely will open up new vistas of IP ownership issues, because, like I told you, though it verifies the ownership using the blockchain technologies, which is unmutable again, so there's going to be authenticity and veracity with regard to the ownership issues. But however, what I can foresee is that there's also going to be multiple IP ownership challenges, because if I am the person who's creating an NFT, do I have the legal right to create NFT? That's going to be the fundamental question that will pop crop up ideally. Because if I do not have any permission or license to create an NFT per se, then my act of creating an NFT without proper permission would itself constitute to be intellectual property infringement, and it can no way grant me an IP ownership or that particular NFT that is created by me or generated by me, for that matter. Now, in this scenario, it'll be a different kind of a ball game altogether when different technologies have been used. Just imagine if artificial intelligence is used for the purpose of generating NFTs. Because what happens is that without human intervention, if an AI system goes ahead and generates an NFT, then who's going to own that particular intellectual property that's arising out of that NFT? That's a very interesting challenge per se. And not just that, if I do not have any kinds of permission or license, can I create that NFTs? So that's another interesting question. And third, if I get a license to create the NFTs from the respective IP owner, would I be considered as a co-owner, or how does it go? Or will my license be adequately enough to actually govern the IP ownership issues? I think these are also some challenges and questions that are likely to pop up as far as ownership is concerned. So I think in a nutshell, I don't want to put too many things in the discussion today, but just to give you a glimpse, I thought I should also take you through these areas per se. Farhan, can we go to the next slide? Yes. Obviously, like I told you, if I create an NFT, there's going to be intellectual property involved. And what happens to the IP rights? That's going to be very interesting, because if I become the owner of this particular intellectual property that is generated out of the NFT, then do I get the rights of an IP owner? That's a very interesting question, because the IP rights are going to be different altogether. Because I, as an IP owner, would have different kinds of rights. I can monetize it and complete or full. I can sell it. I can license it. I can do anything with it. But fundamentally, what becomes very, very important in this scenario is that if I'm not the respective owner and I'm just given a mere license by the owner to create an NFT, would my IP rights still go ahead and be passed to me? Or will they get passed to the owner? That's going to be a very interesting question that requires a lot of discussion and deliberations per se. Yes. Can we go to the next slide, Farhan? Per se, will the creation of these NFTs contribute to intellectual property infringement? Because that's something that we are likely to see by and large out of these NFTs. More specifically, going back to the example of the movie clip, yes, if I create something like that without proper license, without proper permissions, I think that NFT creation itself can amount to an IP infringement. So when it's an IP infringement, it could be copyright infringement that can come in because it's an unauthorized copy. Then if there is a trademark that is involved here, then there could also be trademark infringement here. And if I'm doing that with an intention of any malified or any intention which is likely to cause any kinds of wrongful loss to the IP owner per se, then passing of charges, which is nothing but trademark related infringement aspects, can also be brought on to me when I create and actually try to sell these NFTs. Now, what will be another very interesting area is if I am an NFT marketplace and I'm enabling different kinds of NFT creators to come on board and actually sell my NFTs through the marketplace. What happens to the legal lab particular platforms? I think that's something.
Sir has been disconnected. I'd like all of you to wait shortly so that he joins back.
I'm sorry, I think my connection got out. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what becomes very, very important when it comes to NFTs and IP infringement is that when I make use of these marketplaces, what is the liability of these marketplaces? Would they also be charged for an IP infringement? That's also going to be one interesting area. And how can these marketplaces be bonafide with and then how can they themselves put the onus of responsibility upon the NFT creators? That's going to be a very interesting area per se. Though by and large, these marketplaces are intermediaries under the law, but per se, when it comes to the intellectual property infringements, I think that's also something that is likely to bring in different kinds of challenges on the table, because it is very difficult to understand if the respective creator of the NFT is actually the owner, or if in case he's not the actual owner, does he have the proper license from the IP owner? I think that verification, though it has been done by blockchain technologies, I think that's still going to be bringing in certain amount of challenges for the NFT marketplaces per se. So both the NFT creators as also the NFT marketplaces would have to be paying very good attention to the intellectual property related issues, and they'll have to build robust legal policies covering these intellectual property aspects per se. Can we go to the next slide, Farhan? Okay, just a previous one. Okay. So what is necessary is only what is required. So I don't want to load the complete amount of concepts of NFTs in one session, because this is something that will be requiring a lot of discussions per se. So I would like to do one more session on NFT where I talk about some specific case studies and bring on the table certain specific deliberations from different aspects. But I thought this will act as a key catalyst to bridge the understanding of the intellectual property with respect to the aspect of NFT. So this is just an attempt to just give you some basic information and give you some basic understanding about the different kinds of IP related issues relating to NFTs. So I would like to now open the discussion and then come up with more interactions with the moderators so that we can have some deliberations out of this particular webinar instead of just making it a simple one-sided or let's say a simple lecture on NFT. I thought it would be very interesting in case we have some kind of discussion and deliberations relating to NFTs and IPR, because this is something that requires a lot of key considerations. And I would also request the center if they can come up with some outcome document of this webinar and then put together all these points and then maybe publish this as a report or something like that, so that it'll help the stakeholders going forward with respect to addressing some very important IP related issues relating to NFTs per se.
Definitely, sir. We'll definitely do that. So thank you so much, sir, for this really well-explained session. I think a lot of people have learned so much about NFT today. But of course, with all this information we absorbed, there are a few questions that have come up in our viewers' mind. And I would like to begin with asking you some questions.
Please, go ahead, Maitri.
So the first question that we begin with is with regards to the legality of NFTs right now. As we're all aware, NFTs do not have a codified law as of now. So what do you think and how does that affect the rights of the IP holders as of now?
Yeah. So basically talking about the legalities of NFTs per se, as you rightly pointed out, we don't have any specific law governing NFTs or blockchain or for that matter, any kinds of, crypto assets or crypto tokens. But fundamentally, what I can tell you is that all NFTs, end of the day, broadly speaking, are nothing but information or data in the electronic format. So broadly speaking, the Information Technology Act that is available today, which is the omnipotent legislation as far as digital transactions are concerned, because if you ask me, it is one of the three most important, it would be one of the most significant laws passed by independent India, because I believe that the Information Technology Act is providing legal recognition to all transactions carried out by way of electronic medium. So end of the day, these non-fungible tokens are nothing but information or data in the electronic format. And broadly speaking, they also get recognized legally under the purview of the Information Technology Act per se. But this is just a step which is at the beginning, and we're still in the infant stage. But I believe a lot of work needs to happen specifically with regard to pointing out the legality of NFTs, because there's going to be involvement of crypto, there's going to be involvement of blockchain, there's going to be involvement of all these kinds of technologies. I think a specific codified law is required so as to address the specific nuances being posed by these NFTs per se.
Definitely, sir. Completely agreed. So our next question can be said as a carry forward to this. As we know that there is no legislation, this is one of the challenges we do face when it comes to NFT. So my next question is that there can be challenges one faces while dealing with NFT, especially when it comes with regards to IP challenges that an artist can face. So what are your opinions on that?
Yes, I think there's going to be definitely some amounts of challenges. Number one is, in layman's term, let's say that I'm an artist. I think one of the fundamental areas that I'm likely to be affected is what happens with regard to the ownership of IP. And second thing is, if there's an unauthorized copy, then how am I to seek my legal remedies? Will the existing intellectual property rights give me the legal remedies to go ahead and fight in case of any infringement or any issues that are happening across with respect to this NFTs? I think that's one another challenge that we are likely to see. Then the third important area is what happens to the amount of royalties that are going to be that one receives out of the sale of these NFTs. We don't have a law which is dedicatedly pointing out towards the same. I think that's also something that, as a person who's an artist would be bothered about, because I definitely want to monetize my work, and when I'm doing so, I would also want to understand whether my IP rights can be enforced, or in case to what extent they can be enforced, and what is the kind of revenue percentage that I can receive over such market sales. Because ideally, all these NFT marketplaces have a different kind of a phenomena. For example, let's say that you have put your artwork for a price of 10,000 rupees. So the kind of understanding that these marketplaces today have is that, in a broad nutshell, I don't say every marketplace, but broadly speaking, the common monetizing method that these NFT marketplaces make use of is, if they sell the artwork for more than 10,000 rupees, then there's a different kind of a margin altogether. If they're selling it for 10,000 rupees, which is your market price, then they give you a certain amount of share. And if they sell it over and above, I think they're at an advantage. So that's where I think some kind of legal challenges would have to be brought in, because if the NFT marketplace tries to exploit this intellectual property, I think the IP owner, who's an artist, would also be facing some kinds of revenue related issues that are likely to arise. So I think these are some things that I can see broadly from the NFT IP challenges perspective. And not just that, when these NFTs and blockchain both are conjunctively used, I think there's also a new concept known as DAOs, which are called decentralized autonomous organizations. These are nothing but online communities in blockchain kind of technologies, and they allow these members to actually pool all the resources together for a common purpose. So what will be another legal challenge from an IPR perspective is, do these DAOs have some kinds of ownership on these NFTs? Because that's also something that we'll all have to really put on the discussion, because that's another interesting area. So I probably foresee these to be some of the very important IP challenges that an artist is likely to face when it comes to NFTs. So copyright versus NFT ownership, then protection of these NFTs, specifically the intellectual property, and then the concept of this blockchain and DAOs and intellectual properties and ownerships. Then the other aspect is the ownership, the rights of the intellectual property owner when it comes to NFT, and also the revenue sharing and royalty. So I foresee these to be very, very important IP legal challenges as far as NFTs are concerned.
All right, sir. My next question is that have you personally dealt with any specific instance when it comes to NFT and IPR?
Yes, we are actually trying to advise a couple of NFT market platforms who are trying to come up with marketplaces relating to NFT. Like I told you, they're trying to act as Amazons for NFT. So we are trying to see and build some kinds of legal policies, specifically in the light of intellectual property, because like I told you, the concept of NFT will bring in huge amount of IP related aspects on the table. As a NFT marketplace, what are my roles and responsibilities? What are my due diligence as far as intellectual property is concerned? How do I verify? Though blockchain technology is used for verifying the authorship and the ownership of these NFTs, but per se, how do I verify if this particular NFT creator, if he is not the actual IP right owner, does he have a proper license from the IP owner? So that's something that the NFT marketplaces are all facing as a challenge. Second, the legality of this, is it going to be allowed in India? But broadly, as I told you, IT Act recognizes it, but there is no law per se giving legality to the NFTs in India. So that's another legal challenge that we are battling around. And the third thing is that as an NFT marketplace, what are my legal obligations as far as my marketplace is concerned? How do I ensure that there is no IP infringement happening through my platform? I think that we are trying to address these issues per se. But ultimately, what we are trying to basically zero down is, if there are no proper mechanisms to verify the ownership of the NFT creator, ultimately there has to be some kind of a contract specifically between the NFT buyer and the NFT seller. Terms of this, including the intellectual property, will be governed by these contracts specifically. So we're trying to come up with these kinds of solutions, and how do we prevent any IP related infringements, including the copies that are made out of these digital collectibles per se. That's something that we are actually trying to now work on, and that's giving us different kind of challenges altogether, specifically because internet per se does not have boundaries, and internet has made geography a history. So I think this kind of a scenario, IP challenges are on the galore. So it's rather giving us a lot of challenges to build robust legal policies specifically for these NFT marketplaces from an IPR perspective.
Right, sir. So right now we have a draft bill in the parliament which proposes to ban cryptocurrency. What are your thoughts on this, and how do you think it would affect the current artists who have already started using NFT as a way of selling their artwork?
I think definitely it's not a good move of banning NFTs or for that matter cryptocurrencies, because they're here to stay. I believe instead of giving a complete ban, I think let's try to adopt the other countries' laws, where they're trying to come up with certain kinds of mechanism to actually regulate these cryptocurrencies as also these NFTs per se. I think a good option would be to regulate them and come up with some regulatory mechanism, because we cannot definitely isolate ourselves from technology development. And if we do that, let me tell you, people will start approaching foreign platforms, and there'll be more amount of intellectual property breaches, and the IP owners would have to battle internationally, which will involve a lot of money, costs, and also time per se. So I don't think that's a viable option. But my personal opinion is, instead of giving a complete blanket ban on it, I think some regulatory mechanism would have to be introduced, and we'll have to continue making use of these cryptocurrencies and NFTs, because they are the future. And I believe that understanding and going through different countries' laws and trying to indigenize them to suit our specific IP laws would be the only option that would be viable as far as this is concerned.
That's completely right, sir. So Facebook has now made metaverse a very talked about topic. So do you think that NFT and metaverse has any connection?
Definitely. See, the moment you're making use of metaverse is going to be digital avatars, digital world altogether. And definitely what happens is that I can even monetize and create an NFT of my digital avatar. So which is meaning that NFTs and metaverse together will bring in a lot of legal, regulatory and policy issues on the table, specifically from an IPR perspective. Because if I just imagine that I have a digital avatar and I'm making use of the digital avatar in the digital space, so this is nothing but metaverse. But if I want to monetize that, and if I want to go ahead and create an NFT for this digital avatar, then it's going to be a different challenge altogether, because who owns that digital avatar will be fundamentally the question that has to be answered. And if that is answered, can the NFT of that digital avatar also be capable enough for IP protection will be another area that we'll have to consider. So it will be, I think, throwing up.
I think sir has lost connection. He'll be with us shortly.
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
We apologize for all the inconveniences caused. There has been a network issue.
Am I audible now, Maitri?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. So I think metaverse has already now become the ground reality. Now, digital avatars, protection of these intellectual property, specifically relating to digital avatars and the digital space, and making use of the same through an NFT and monetizing that will bring in different kinds of IP challenges. Lawmakers and people who are actually the stakeholders would have to keep this in mind and ensure that there is some direction or of work happening in this area, because metaverse is something that's throwing up different kinds of IP legal challenges altogether. And more so, NFT and metaverse together will open up new vistas of IP legal challenges. So I think they have to be specifically addressed, and because of the given the fact that there are different kinds of modalities and technicalities involved, I think specific legal nuances will arise in this direction per se.
Definitely, sir. So the last but not the least, our final question is, how do you view the value of an NFT changing based on people's perception and its interplay with intellectual property?
I think, we are in a golden rush of moving towards the era of NFTs. I think almost all artists today, whether they're actors, whether they're professional artists, or they are musicians, or they are people who are painters. I think all these artists are now looking at monetizing their artwork, and this is going ahead. And then this is by and large happening through NFTs. So what is very, very important is that unless there is good amount of IP protection provided in case of NFTs, I think the concept of NFTs would be facing a lot of gray areas. So I think, according to me, a proper balance has to be put in, because NFT creators are people who are actually trying to generate a lot of intellectual property that has to be protected. At the same time, their IP valuation has to be in such a way that they also get some monetization out of these NFTs, and that also has to be done in a proper format. I think IP licensing and IP assignments, specifically with regard to NFTs, would be something that would have to looked into as an immediate option, because now we're in a golden rush. Everybody is almost looking at NFTs and then they're moving ahead in that direction per se.
Right, sir. So with this, I would like to end this wonderful evening filled with insightful knowledge. I hope all of you are now well aware about NFTs and are ready to lead in conversations on the same with your friends and families. On behalf of ICIPL and Law Essentials India, it is my privilege to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion to all the people who made this event successful. To begin with, I would like to thank Advocate Sai Sushant, who stepped in and made the very complex subject of NFT easier and understandable for all of us. We know how busy you are, sir, and it was so kind of you to take out your time on a weekend for all of us. I would then like to thank my co-moderator, Farhan, for putting in his efforts to make this event possible. Finally, I would like to thank all of you, our dear viewers, for joining us on a Sunday evening. I hope the session helped you in learning something new. Thank you so much, everyone, and I hope you have a wonderful evening ahead.